Hey guys, today I want to talk about the true tribe of Judah, which are the Xhosa people of South Africa from Nelson Mandela's clan. We do according to scriptures, okay? Because it is written in the book in Isaiah 14, 1 and 2, that Judah, which was sent away, will come back, and when he comes back, he will take the rulership from those who oppressed him. And when you look at the whole of the continent of Africa, I don't know anybody else who went away. Wending away from this means Nelson Mandela being in prison for 27 years, and when he came back, then he took the rulership from those who oppressed him. We know about South African apartheid and all that. Nobody else fit this scripture more than Nelson Mandela. Nobody. I mean, he is the only one that suit this scripture. Okay. Now, you see the bag Nelson Mandela has on his neck. This is the very same bag the Mustache told Moses to put his hand in and out. So who are the children of Israel? The children of Israel are beyond the rivers of Cush, and their God is so nini nanini, everlasting existence. As you see these fake Jews now, they are copying the attire of the Nelson Mandela. Why are they doing that? Because they know they are the true Judah. This is Umsindisi from village to city, which he went from Eastern Cape into Jerusalem, and then there he was crucified. So we want to talk about the language, okay? The language of the people of the children of Israel, which is Aramaic, you know, is taken from their father Aram. And you can see even when Christ was on the cross, he screamed with a loud voice and said, Eli, Eli, Elama Sabbatane, which means this is for the Sabbath keeper. In the book of Deuteronomy 28:49, it's talking about that the Messiah, because of the Israelites, they rebelled against his covenant, he will send people from far, far away, a nation that is swooping like an eagle. And we know that an eagle is an emblem of the European countries, you know. And they came and they oppressed the Bantu people of South Africa through the apartheid, you know, and forced them into, you know, in the language, because it's talking about the language that they will not understand, and then they will react because they despise this language, which is Africans. And all this is happening where? In South Africa. When you look at the South Africans, the way they dress, in their traditional wear, they wear fringes, okay? They live the Bible without having to know that they're living the Bible, because when you look at the culture, what they are eating, the houses they're living in, is all scriptural, right? And even something so bizarre like, you know, vuvuzela. You know, vuvuzela is when they were blowing the trumpet on the first of the seventh month. They were blowing this trumpet. But today they use vuvuzela for football and all that stuff, okay? And even the way we grill the meat, the way we do shisa nyama is all scriptural, okay? The houses we're living in, what we are eating, our attire, our traditional attire, and even I want to include also the circumcision, you know, because a circumcised boy must be 13 years, not like it is written in the Bible, like 8 years, 8 days, okay? No, it's not to do with that, because it is written also that from this 13 year, when these boys, they go to the mountains and to be circumcised. They have been taught the way, the way of lives, in order for them to be able to take over as the head of the family. They have been taught there to be brave and whatever, okay? And then you can have a baby of 8 days, and then you say, okay, after all the circumcision, because after the circumcision you become a man, you can be a man with 8 days. So there are a lot of things that are written in the Bible which are not, you know, supposed to be in the Bible. Let me say they've been injected because the scrolls were stolen, you know, in Jerusalem, in Cape West province of South Africa. Is between Cape West and Namibia. Remember that Namibia belongs to South Africa, is the 10th province. It was only divided because of the colonization, right? But it belongs to South Africa as the 10th province, all right? And then Jerusalem is between Namibia, Lesotho, Botswana, and South Africa. This is what the Bible called the isles surrounding Jerusalem, okay? And Jerusalem is now desolated and is inhabited by jackals, you know, hyenas, you know, or what they call it, wild dogs, you know. But it is in this area of the Kalahari Desert, okay? Things what we see, sometimes, you know, that's why the Bible say that test every spirit, because not every spirit is from the Most High. There are a lot of things which have been injected in the Bible in order to lead us astray, okay? Because there's no how a slave master and a slave can worship the same God. It doesn't make sense at all right? But these are the things that have been injected. These are Egyptology and the Greek mythology, that and their gods, their pagan gods have been injected. About Jesus and Yahweh and all this, Jehovah and all that, you know, because we know that Jehovah was like whatever they call the tentacles. It doesn't even make sense that Christ himself is a Bantu, is born from the Bantu community. He must have a Bantu name or a Bantu title, that we call him Umsindisi. Because why? You know, the Bantu people, they give children names according to what they're coming to do. Before Bantu people, you know, rebelled against the covenant and all that, they had the prophet, and every time when somebody's pregnant, the Most High will give a name to this child because of what he's coming to be. I mean, I'm talking about the destiny of the child is in the name already. So that's why Umsindisi, Christ is Umsindisi, meaning savior. Okay, because he said that he is born for this one thing, to save the people of Israel. It's written also in Hebrews 9:15. He said, for the because of our forefathers who rebelled against the covenant of the Most High, who lusted after pagan gods, they lost every glorious, you know, they are down, you know, they are the last. That's why you see black people being the last and, you know, being hated and all that. It's all because of the curses. And the curses came because of our forefathers rebelled against the covenant which they made with the Most High, and they lusted after pagan gods. So Christ had to come to redeem those who were in the old covenant, according to Hebrews 9:15. He came to restore everything which was lost and to redeem those who were in the old covenant. And we know that the covenant was between the Most High and the Bantu people, the children of Israel. You can see clearly even the Bible, the writings of the Bible. You can see, if you have an eye to see, you can see that even when what Christ said on the cross, Eli, Eli, Elama Sabatani, Tali Takum, when he was raising this damsel, a little girl, from death, and even when he was praying for his disciple, he said, Baba, Abba, Laba, Wangniga Bona, from Emhlabeni. So because these people, they don't understand our language, or they did because of deceptions, we don't know. But they took the Abba and they said Abba is the name of the Most High. No, Abba is not the name of the Most High. Abba is not a name. Abba means these, those, they, okay? It's not a name. So people, they run with stuff because it is written like this. And the people who mistranslated our book, they already made a dictionary for you to get more and more stupid. You go into this dictionary and then you want to translate everything. The name of the Muslim need no translations, okay? Because this name was revealed by Christ to the tribe of Judah, which were isolated in West Cape, South Africa. This is where even Christ died. Okay, he died in Capernaum. The Bible called this place Capernaum. This is where Christ died. He left the Eastern Cape because he said that, because these people rejected him. They said, no, we know you. You cannot be our Messiah because we know you. You are the son of Joseph, the carpenter. And how can you claim to be, you know, from heaven? But, you know, we saw you grew up here and all that. They rejected him, and then he said that a prophet is not accepted in their own town. So he left for Jerusalem, which is West Cape, okay? And when he get there, he had to go there because he had to fulfill that what was written about him. And in West Cape there, like I said, the Xhosa people with the Khoi or the Bushmen people, they were living in peace together, even mingling, you know. So when the European came, they created their own empire, the Roman Empire, in Cape Town. Okay, so when you study the book, you think these things are happening in somewhere in Europe. No, it doesn't make sense. Okay, it doesn't make sense at all, because there must be a sea. There are a lot of things which are playing a role to, you know, for South Africa, even Cape Town, Cape West, to be the place where biblical locations, you know. And, you know, when you go there, when you visit South Africa, Cape Town, I think if you go with me, I will show you, you know, even the Garden of Eden is there. I mean, Cape West is like, you know, I don't know, maybe the Mustache just made it the way it is. So that's why you see also that this European, they have been they are flooded into Cape West. Why? Because they're also... Not only because it is beautiful, it is, you know, stunning, okay? Cape Town is very stunning, it's beautiful, all right? And the air there is different. I mean, when you go there, you will feel something. But anyway, so they are after the Asian powers. And they use these Asian powers against its people, which are the Bantu people of South Africa. They created and built also a satanic temple there. The Bible said the Antichrist will sit on the congregation of the children of the Most High. You still looking in the Middle East? The Middle East is fake. The people there are fake, because those people you call Jews, actually, they came from North Germany, from the Asian Empire of the North Germany, which they called the Ostrogoths and the Vandals, including also with the Arabs, which actually came from Turkey, and they're going around into Spain, the mingling, and then they enter North Africa, and then they invaded North Africa. The people who actually are the original people of North Africa, the Nile Valley, according to scripture, is Isu. Isu is not a black man. Isu are the Hausa tribe of Nigeria, and they are also spread all over West Africa, you know, and also in East Africa, in the region of Sudan and all these places, okay? These are the true Egyptians. These are the true the children of Ham, above equator. When you look at the African map, above equator is where the territory of the children of Ham are, according to Genesis 10:19, till Asia, because it's talking about till is from Sidon till Asia, Tibet, the land of gods. We're talking about Asia, India, there where they have a lot of 100,000 of pagan gods and all that, okay? So now we're finding also the Asian maps, which now shows the places, you know. You can visit our brother, Truth Unveiled. You know, he's teaching about all this. He has all these maps and he's teaching about them, where is what, and he's revealing, exposing the true biblical locations, which are in the Southern Kingdom, right? Southern Kingdom, talking about South Africa, Botswana, Lesotho, Zimbabwe, and Namibia, all right? These people, as I've mentioned them, these are the family, the Bantu people. These are the territory of the Bantu people, according to Zephaniah 3:10. From beyond the rivers of Cush, my scattered people, my daughters, the daughters of my dispersed, will bring me offerings on that day. And when you look where the territory is starting from the equator line, as you see it, you know, going down into the tip of South Africa. The thing is, and when I'm talking about the language, the Israelites were never called Hebrews or Jews, no ways, okay? According to Deuteronomy 26, 5 to 8, it's talking about the period when they left from Canaan into Egypt. These were called the Aramean after their father Aram, because the Israelites were only called after their father Aram, Shem, which they were called the Shemites after Shem, their father, and Aram, the Aramites, and then Jacob, his Israelites, which is his name is Isakele, by the way, but maybe they mistranslated Isakele and they called Israel. I don't know, or it's just the, you know, the method of them, of their deceptions and all that. So that's why we always have to test scriptures. It says that in the book of Deuteronomy 25:26. Verse 5 to 8, that my father was an Aramean. He left Canaan land, where the Israelites dwell, and he went into Egypt because there was famine, there was starvation in Canaan land. That's the reason why the Israelites, they had to go to Egypt to go and buy grain. When they get there, you know the story of Joseph, and then he allowed them to stay there. And he gave them position, so they became mighty. And then the Egyptians, they were scared that the Israelites would take over their land. And then they started to enslave them. All right, this is how slavery came into being. And then when you see, you look at the language, you know, Daniel 5, 25, mene, mene, tekele, opanzele. This is the language that is being spoken in South Africa till date. All the Bantu people, when they want to say to a person, you are sneaky, you are backbiting, you are a snake, you are not trustworthy, all these things, they'll say to you, uli mene mene. All the Bantu people, they're using the very same phrase, uli mene mene. Okay, so now, all this is exposing. You can visit our sister also, Joni John, the Bantu words in the Bible, and then she's exposing all this and also explaining the true names of the prophets who wrote the scriptures, the people who called Jeremiah and all the, and even the disciples, Abo Peter and Abo Ban, they have their own Bantu names. And our sister, Joni John, she's in the States. She is helping us to understand the meaning of all this name, and the Most High be with her, bless her. Kudos to you, my sister Joni John. Because of her, now we understand all these things. We never understood what was happening and all that. We all were deceived and believed that the fake Jews, actually, which are the Nazis from Germany, from North Germany, you know, I mean, the scripture said they're Ashkenazi, they're Khazarian. Okay, these people are Europeans, and the European people are the sons of Japheth, according to scripture. They are the Gog and Magog. They have no connection with what is to do with the Bible or the children of Israel, because the children of Israel are black, according to scriptures. Job 30:30, Lamentation 4:8, our skin is as dark as coal. And Lamentation, when you take it in the book of Jubilees, it goes further, because it is expressed or exposing the shape, the physical shape of of the tuna visual, with their thick lips, their flat nose, and all that, and the wool hair. We know that is Africa, because white people cannot be black because they do not possess any melanin in their skin. All right. So this video is all about Mandela and his clan. These are the people of Judah. Okay, and he took over the rulership, and the true name of the Master is Sonini Nanini. And then when we get into how the European came in, and then it's talking also expressing the fact of that the people, the Israelites, they did not like that the language of their oppressors. We're talking about Africans. I know all Africans were oppressed, but this one is expressing that there had to be a conflict between these European and the Bantu people because of the Africans' language, which caused a lot of conflict, not only conflict, but civil war. You know, people died because of this. And the scripture said that they will hate, and our people in South Africa, they hate this language, Africans, for nothing else because it's most difficult language for them. Accordingly, even the Bible is expressing that because they will despise this language because it's difficult. They don't understand it. It doesn't matter how hard they try to learn, they don't understand it. Unless maybe you grew up in the farm and your family were the slave farms, and there, and then you had a boss or your master was speaking Africans, then maybe so you can learn. But nobody really, you know. And according to the traditions, you know, we see they call, you know, the mistranslation of words and all that, you know, the way the tribe of Judah dressed, that the fake Jews had to copy. It's not the stripes, the black and white stripes, but these are fringes. And Judah should wear white because Judah is a king, is from the royal family. Judah is royal, you know. Christ came from the royal family. Christ is the lion of the tribe of Judah. According to the totems, the animal totems of the Judah people, they have the lion in their clans as the emblem of their forefathers. Okay? So please repent. Repent and follow the law of the Most High, and do according to his will, so he will bless you. In the Bible is written, the only thing I think that will help South Africa, because South Africa is supposed not to be the way it is. It is also a punishment of the sins of our forefathers, which they don't even want to repent. All right. So the Most High said in 2 Chronicles 7:14, he said, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and get rid of all this abomination, what they are doing, about transgender, about homosexual, sodomites, and all that. These people are doing these things because we're living with white people who wants to have this, and they call that human rights, okay? So in the book of 2 Chronicles 7:14, the Most High said, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and stop doing wickedness, but seek my face in prayers, then I will exalt them over all the nations of the earth, and I will heal their land. You know that the South Africans have been taken, their land was taken by the Europeans, but the Most High said he will replace it. To heal is to replace it, to give it to the rightful owner, only when they repent. So guys, come out from all these pagan churches you call Christianity.